have trouble signing up online, like some people have been like, I can't get my password, I can't, then just show up. It's not been full, rarely, so we can always, there's 2 extra spots just in case, but until it starts like filling up, then just come. I just want you to be here. So let's go ahead and get started. I'm actually going to have you guys start in child's pose today. So you find your variation of child's pose, whether it's knees wide, knees together, your hips rest back towards your heels, your forehead rest down on your mat. And if that feels too uncomfortable to take your hips all the way back to your heels, then just keep your hips a little bit higher up in the air. So try to get to a place where you can relax, where you can give your weight to the ground, give your weight to the earth. And then just take a moment to really, truly arrive here fully. So not just physically, but also energetically, emotionally, mentally. So feel into this space, feel the ground underneath you, the air around you. Feel into your body. So sensations, pulsations, even notice thoughts that are there or emotions that are there. Also notice your breath. Next time you breathe in, fill up as big as you can. Think of moving your inhale all the way down into your low belly, your low back. Hold in that fullness and even see if you can sip in just a little bit more. And then when you're ready, exhale, open mouth, sigh, let it go. Do that twice more. So inhale, fill up. Feel your entire body expand and inflate with your breath. Exhale, big open mouth sigh, release. We got one more time. So biggest inhale you've taken all morning long thus far. Just think of waking up your body with this breath. Hold. And then exhale, let it go. Ha. Start to cultivate your ujjayi breath, so in and out through your nose by way of the back of your throat. Start to create that little whisper noise or that oceanic sound with your breath. And you can stay here in your child's pose, just resting, just connecting, just tuning in to yourself, to your breath for as long as you'd like. When you feel ready for some movement, keep your breath going and transition onto your hands and your knees, so just a tabletop position. And you guys know the drill, just start to explore movement through your spine. So maybe cat-cows, maybe hip circles. You might even come all the way forward towards cobra or up dog. Might even sit all the way back onto your heels in a hero's pose, a kneeling position. Maybe take your arms up and stretch. So go wherever your body is calling for you to go. Just use this time to kind of take a little bit of an inventory of how you are this morning, of how you feel, of what's going on inside. So what feels really good, really open, maybe really strong. And then what might feel a little bit tight or stiff or sore or tender, move towards that sensation, breathe into it, soften around it. Give yourself about 5 more breaths here, just simply exploring, no right or wrong. I like to close my eyes, especially for this first part, just allow myself to go more inward. So think of it as just a moving meditation with your body. And then once you feel complete here, downward facing dog is our eventual destination. So you can get there in your own time, whenever you are ready. Thank you. job, you guys. And as you move into your down dog, do it with awareness. So make sure your fingers are spreading nice and wide. Really press down through the pads of your fingertips. And even think of pressing the ground forward and away. Lift your hips super high. So imagine that rope or that string that I always talk about. It's attached to your belly button. It's pulling up towards the ceiling and then tugging towards the back of the room. So really create that length from your fingertips up to your sit bones. If you want to pedal out your heels, walk out your dog, maybe shake your head yes or no. You can even stretch one leg up and then the other if it calls to you. So just feel into this posture right here, right now. What can you notice? What can you observe? And then how can you adjust to perhaps get a little bit more out of it? Be a little more efficient in your body. And then can you still feel your big, deep, expansive breaths moving and flowing through you? So use your breath as much as possible to support you. Your breath is your tool. It's not just something that you have to worry about. It's not just a distraction. It is what brings you into your practice, into your body, into this present moment. You guys look great. Take one more big inhale and see if you can lift your sit bones just a little bit higher. Maybe lengthen through your side bodies a little bit more. Exhale, look forward, and however you want to get there, feet to the top of your yoga mat, forward fold. Stay in your fold for just a moment. If you want to take ragdoll pose, grab opposite elbows, go for it. If you want to bring your hands behind your head and interlace your fingers at the base of your skull, that might feel nice to get the back of your neck some traction. You might even feel that up into your back body. Breathe into it. Notice where you're holding the weight in your feet. Try to keep your weight slightly forward so your heels are very light against the ground. And then lift your sit bones as high as you can. So even if you have a big bend in your knees, imagine you're trying to lift your butt super, super high and then reach the crown of your head closer to the ground. Take a couple more big, deep breaths. Perhaps visualize your breath flowing up your spine and then moving all the way down the backs of your legs. Next time you breathe in, find a halfway lift, so spinal extension. Pause here for just a moment and really get all the rounding out of your back. So top of your head reaches forward, back of your neck is long, and then press the tops of your thighs back, broaden through your sit bones, and imagine you're trying to lift your sit bones towards the sky. Notice if you've let go through your belly. Pull your belly button in and up. See if you can lengthen just a little bit more. Take one more big inhale. Nice, you guys, good Sandy. Exhale, release, forward fold. And your choice, you can either roll or reverse swan dive all the way up to stand. Inhale to stretch your arms up, maybe even gaze up. And exhale, hands to heart center, Anjali Mudra. Flow with your breath, so half sun salutes. Inhale, high mountain, stretch tall. Exhale, slow swan dive down, forward fold. So take your time, traction out your spine, then fold in. As you breathe in, halfway lift. Get all the rounding out of your back. Stay connected at your core. Beautiful. Exhale, refold. Nice, Nick. From the press of your feet, reverse swan dive to stand. As you rise, hug your back muscles around your spine. Reach your arms up. Inhale. Exhale, hands to heart. And we'll do one more round just like that. See if you can use even more awareness. Inhale, high mountain. Exhale, perhaps close your eyes as you slowly dive down. So just feel your body moving through space from the inside out. As you breathe in, halfway lift, spine parallel to the ground, Ardha Uttanasana. Beautiful. Exhale, refold, Uttanasana. Press into your feet, lead with your heart, rise to stand. Back muscles hug around your spine. Inhale, reach up, stretch tall. Exhale, hands to heart center, Anjali Mudra. All right, inhale, take your arms to the sky. And as you exhale, step your right foot off the right side of your yoga mat. Hold 10 bug back and reach your arms forward. So think of your arms and your spine parallel to the ground. Weight is in your heels. Try not to let your knees fall in. Track them out towards your pinky toe. Now with your arms, imagine you're trying to press them up towards the ceiling, and at the same time, you're trying to press your chest towards the ground. See if you can bend your knees more and reach your butt back a little bit further, so get lower in your legs. Next time you inhale, come back to center, high mountain, so stretch and lengthen, open to the front of your hips. Exhale, other side, so left foot steps to the left, arms reach forward, butt reaches back. So you're in a squat position. Try not to let your spine round. Keep the back of your neck nice and long. So it's like you're doing a halfway lift with your spine, but your arms are reaching forward like you're in Warrior Three. Press your chest down, press your arms up. Maybe get a little bit deeper into your legs. Maybe pick up your toes, spread them apart. One more round. Thanks, Sarah. Good, Cam. Inhale, come back to your high mountain. Arms reach up and stretch. Exhale, bring your hands behind your back and interlace your fingers. Roll your shoulders back and down, hug shoulder blades towards your spine. And if you want to intensify this a little bit, press your palms together and squeeze your elbows towards each other. At the same time, imagine you're trying to pull your fingers apart like they're super glued together. Now keep that and start to reach your hands back away from your body. Possibly create a little back bend. So heart lifts up as knuckles reach down. Your hips press gently forward, but your low belly stays toned. Take one more big inhale into the front of your heart. Hands stay clasped. Exhale, hinge at your hips. Dive down slowly, forward fold. Take about two breaths with your fingers interlaced in your forward fold. So let your neck relax. Let your head be very heavy. You can bend your knees a little or a lot and see if you can lift your sit bones higher, lift your knuckles higher, feel that stretch through the front of your shoulders. Take one more inhalation, exhale, hands to your low back, release your clasp, you can let your arms hang for a moment, and then as you are ready, on an in-breath, find a halfway lift, just realigning your spine. Exhale, plant your hands, and we'll meet back in plank position, so top of a push-up. Take a moment in this first plank posture to really find your strength here. So press the ground away, think of pushing the ground away, breathe into your back body, draw your navel towards your spine. If you want to modify at any time, knees can always come down, otherwise knees are lifted and the front of your thighs are firing, so your quads are engaged. See if you can hold this position, but just start to rock ever so slightly forward and back. So you're coming forward onto your tippy toes, you're pressing your heels back and lengthening through the backs of your legs. Just a little tiny movement, don't let your belly drop. Next time you inhale, come forward onto your tiptoes or lower your knees to modify. Exhale, halfway down. So strong arms, strong belly, even strong legs. Inhale, press back up, high plank. Exhale one more time, little rock forward, lower halfway. Try not to let your shoulders roll forward. Inhale, press back up, straighten your arms, and then slow as you can go all the way down to your belly. Nice work, good Emily. Inhale, baby cobra. So lift your chest using back strength rather than arm strength. Keep your gaze slightly down so the back of your neck stays long. Roll your shoulders back and down, elbow tips point straight back behind you. Now bring some awareness into your lower body. Press firmly into your shoelaces and into your pelvis. And imagine you're trying to pull your belly button up away from the ground. Now keep that, float your hands up and reach your hands back towards your heels. So try not to lift your feet, keep your shoelaces rooted, spread through your toes and try to press your toenails down. Now with your arms, bend into your elbows, turn your palms to face each other or to face towards the ground. And imagine your elbows are magnetized, try to squeeze them closer together. And as you do so, feel your mid-back muscles fire. See if you can lift just a little bit higher, bring all the way down into your belly. One more huge deep breath. Good job. End of your exhale, let it go. Release. Spider-Man Cobra. So hands hands come out to frame your mat. Lift to your fingertips, elbows face the sky. Inhale, lift your heart. Bring your hands out wide. And exhale, twist to the right. Dip your left shoulder down. Inhale, come back to center. Lift your heart, tone your belly. Exhale, other side, twist. I think this always feels so good at the beginning of practice. Inhale, come back to center. Go once more in each direction with your own breath at your own pace. Feel into the mobility in your spine, in your shoulders, in your neck. Eventually, an inhale will bring you back to center. You can exhale to let it go, to release. And however you would like to get there, downward facing dog. Transition back. Time, you've got about 5 deep breaths. You're welcome to explore with any type of movement that feels good. You're welcome to just be still, or I like to give the option to turn this one into a turbo dog. So if you want to go there, the only thing that you'll change is your arms. Bend your elbows a lot and then squeeze them in towards each other so your forearms hover just an inch or so above the ground. Good, Crystal. Keep lifting your hips really high. Keep lengthening through your spine and your side bodies. Awesome, Josh. And then see if you can make your breath even bigger, even more powerful. Nice job, everybody. Take one more great big inhale so you can lift your hips even higher. Exhale, gaze forward, empty out first, step tiptoe or hop forward, full top of your mat. Halfway lift, breathe in, find length. Exhale, bow, refold. Root through your feet, rise all the way up to stand. Inhale, high mountain, stretch tall. Exhale, hands to heart center. All right, breath to movement for just a moment. Inhale, arms to the sky. Exhale, right foot steps to the right. Bend your knees, butt back, arms forward, spine long. Inhale, come back to center, reach high, and then exhale, other side, left foot steps left, reach forward, butt back, spine really long. Inhale, high mountain, stretch. This time as you exhale, cactus your arms, lift and open through your heart, hips gently forward. Inhale, arms re-extend, lots of length, neutralize your spine, and exhale, slow. Dive down, forward fold. With your inhalation, halfway lift. How much length can you create? Exhale, plunge your hands, step or float back. Move through your own vinyasa however you would like. So you can add a couple push-ups. You can take it on your knees. You can skip it all together. Maybe substitute cows. And then eventually back to downward facing dog. From your down dog, next time you inhale, right leg to the sky. So press your right foot back and up. Press your hands forward and down. For this one, try to keep your hips square so your inner thighs face each other. And then I don't care so much how high your right leg goes, but see if you can make it straighter and stronger, more powerful. So if I came over to you and pressed down on the back of your right leg, it would not even move. It's so strong and powerful. Take one more big inhale, see if you can lengthen just a tiny bit more. And then exhale, right knee to your nose. So curl in, hollow out your belly. You should be high on the ball of your back foot, shoulders over wrists. Stay here as you breathe in, push the ground away. And exhale, step your right foot to the top of your yoga mat, lunge, and then take it up to crescent lunge in your own time. So you can take a moment to kind of find your alignment, find your stability. So front knee over front ankle, high on the ball of your back foot. Get your back leg as straight as you can. You can bend your knee a little bit or a lot if it bothers your low back. Think of driving your feet down into the earth, and then energetically pull your front heel back and your back toes forward. See if you can feel that little tone through your low abdominal. So you're not squeezing your abs, but you're also not just letting go through your belly. It's that nice neutral spine you're creating. Lift through your heart, reach through your fingertips. Maybe even take your gaze slightly up. Possibly even try closing your eyes for a moment and just feel this pose on the inside. Take one more great big inhale. And then as you exhale, turbo lunge. So bend your back knee, cactus your arms. Back knee hovers above the ground. Imagine you're trying to pull your back thigh forward. You can stay here or option to work a back bend. So bottom tips of shoulder blades hug towards your spine and then start to curl open through your chest. Think of creating your back bend from your mid and your upper back rather than your low back. Wherever you're at, take two more full rounds. Maybe kiss the ground with your back knee. Just let it tap down very lightly. Nice job. Inhale back to crescent lunge. And just for fun, stay straighten out your front leg. Exhale, bring your hands to the ground so you can bend your knee as you bring your hands down. And then left hand stays down, right arm to the sky, recall, lunge, find a twist. So legs very strong, keep your back leg especially very powerful. So imagine the power of this pose is coming from your back leg. Squeeze through your inner thighs and then twist from your center, from your belly button. If you want an extra little challenge here, see if you can really fire up through your legs, engage through your core, and then just hover your left hand above the ground. Nothing else moves, nothing else changes. Nice work. Take one last full round. Good, Emily. End of your exhale, unwind. Root down into your right foot, standing splits, left leg to the sky. So I don't care if you keep your hips square or if you open your left hip, just make sure you're doing it with awareness. So try not to sink into your outer right hip. Your right inner thigh hugs in and then your belly button lifts up. You can go wherever you want to go to explore this posture. So maybe you wrap your right arm behind your right leg. Maybe you plant your palms and lift to your right tiptoes. So you're setting up for handstand hops. If you want to take a few hops, go for it. So feel free to explore and play. Remember, this is just a practice. So give your own body what it's calling for. Let go of what is right or wrong. You can even let go of my cues. Think of them as suggestions or invitations. You guys are awesome. See if you can lift your left leg a little bit higher. Maybe spread your left toes a little bit more. Now listen, take one more big inhale. Exhale, Shiva squat. So left knee tucks into the back of your right knee. Curl in. Inhale, re-extend. Standing splits. We're going to do two more like that. Exhale, Shiva squat. So left knee to the back of right knee. Left heel towards your left butt cheek. Nose towards your knees. Inhale, re-extend. So you can lengthen even more. This is your last one. Exhale, Shiva squat. Inhale, lengthen, and then exhale, forward fold. So step your left foot down next to your right foot at the top of your mat. Bring your big toes to touch, little gap in between your heels, and then find your little tiny potato bug ball pose. So butt towards the ground, nose in between your knees. You can keep your hands down to help with balance, or if it's available to you, wrap your arms around the fronts of your shins and give yourself a big squeeze. Breathe into your back body, into your back ribs. Each time you exhale, see if you can find that deepest part of yourself, your very, very center. Pull your belly button back towards your spine and get even smaller. Nice job. Take one more big deep breath. And then inhale, halfway lift. So set your heels on the ground, spine parallel to the earth. Exhale, plant your hands, step back to plank pose. Pause in your plank, right hand is your foundation. Roll onto the baby toe edge of your right foot, side plank, Vashisasana. So left arm to the sky. If you want to modify by bringing your right knee to the ground, that's fine with me. Unless your right knee is down, then focus on lifting your hip. get super, super high, like you're trying to create a rainbow shape with your body. Option to reach your left arm forward past the top edge of your mat, nice cam. Option to float your left leg up or a leg variation of your choice. Awesome, Sarah. You guys look so good. Take two more deep breaths. Soften your face, unclench your jaw. One last inhale. Exhale to your plank or modified plank. Lower all the way down, chaturanga. Inhale, curl open, lift through your heart. And then just for a moment, to give your wrists a moment to rest, child's pose, sit back, take a couple breaths, reconnect to yourself, reconnect to each inhale, each exhale. See if you can make your breath even bigger, even more powerful. So my personal opinion is that the breath is everything. It's what helps us find even more space inside of our bodies that we didn't even know existed. So rather than tuning the breath out, make it the most important part of your practice as you're ready, downward facing dog.
Is it still flowing?
your body. Try to keep your face nice and soft, your neck relaxed. Nice job, you guys. Take one last big inhale, maybe one last little hop, and then exhale to your Shiva squat. Right knee tucks into the back of your left knee, so both knees bend, nose towards your knees, get small. Inhale, re-extend, standing splits. You've got two more. Exhale, Shiva squat. Think of moving in slow motion. Nice. Inhale, re-extend. Exhale, Shiva squat. Empty all the way out. Inhale, extend for the last time. So reach as high as you can. Exhale, forward fold. Bring your big toes to touch. Find your little tiny potato bug ball. Curl into yourself. So some of you might be able to leave your heels down. If you're like me, I have to lift my heels up because my ankles don't have that flexibility. So maybe if your heels are lifted, try to press your heels towards the ground. Work the flexibility there. Option to wrap your arms around the fronts of your shins. Or sometimes I like to spider crawl my fingertips forward and really press the ground forward and down and use that as leverage to go deeper into myself, to curl in even more. Take one more great big deep breath. Inhale, halfway lift, so realign your spine. Exhale, plant your hands, step back to plank pose. Pause here, side plank, Vashisthasana. Left hand is your base. Roll onto the baby toe edge of your left foot. Nice, Emily, right arm to the sky. Lift your hips super, super high. Good, Sandy. Option to reach your right arm forward, lengthen through your right side body. Breathe into your right side body. Option to float your right leg up or find a leg variation of your choice. Give yourself a couple more breaths to work the posture, to feel into it, to soften around it. See if you can lift your hips even higher than you thought you could. So think of that crescent moon shape or that rainbow shape. One last inhale. Exhale, plank or modified plank, lower down, chaturanga. Inhale to lift your heart, roll your shoulders back and down, and either down dog or if you want, just a moment in your child's pose to rest through your wrists. And eventually downward facing dog. Just take a moment to walk it out, to reconnect, to come back. Feel into your body. Feel the energy moving through you, the energy that you are creating with this conscious breathing, this mindful movement. If you're in a child's pose, take it back to down dog. We're going to take that entire sequence, breath to movement, two times through. If at any time you want to modify, you want to pause or rest, please feel free. So it is your practice. Always listen to yourself first. Take one more big inhale into your down dog. Exhale, gaze forward, empty out, step or float, forward fold, top of your mat. Once you've arrived, spinal extension, breathe in, lengthen. Exhale, bow, fold in. From the press of your feet, reverse, swan dive to stand. Inhale, stretch your arms up. Exhale, hands to heart center, and here we go. Inhale, arms to the sky, high mountain. Exhale, right foot steps to the right, bear pose. So arms forward, butt back, bend your knees a lot, spine is long. Big inhale, come back to center, stretch, open the front of your hips. Exhale, other side, so get as low as you can, spine parallel to the ground. Inhale, back to center, reach and stretch. Exhale, work your back bend. Cactus your arms, lift and open through your heart. Inhale, back to center, so neutralize your spine, stretch super tall. Exhale, slow swan dive down, ride your breath down, forward fold. Try not to be in any sort of hurry. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, plant your hands, step or hop back, chaturanga dandasana, high to low push-up. Inhale, curl open, shoulders back and down, tips of your elbows point back. Exhale, downward facing dog, lift your hips high. Inhale, right leg to the sky, active through your right foot, strong through your right leg. Now use your core strength, exhale, right foot, top of your mat, lunge. Strong legs, inhale, rise up, crescent lunge, reach up, knees up. Exhale, turbo lunge, and you can add the back bend if you want to, if it will serve you. Inhale, back to crescent, so realign, option to straighten your front leg if you'd like. Exhale, hands to the ground, low lunge. Inhale, revolve lunge, right arm to the sky, maybe gaze up at your right fingertips, open up. Exhale, unwind, root into your right foot, and inhale, standing splits, left leg high. Just one time, exhale, Shiva squat, left knee tucks into the back of your right knee, get small. Inhale, standing splits. If you'd like, you can take one little handstand pop. And then exhale, forward fold, big toes touch, curl into your little tiny potato bug ball. Inhale, halfway lift, so realign, re-lengthen. Exhale, plant your hands, step back to plank. You can hold here, or inhale, Vashisthasana, right hand is your base, left arm to the sky, open it up. Exhale, back to your plank or modified plank, lower down, chaturanga. Inhale, lift your heart, shoulders back and down. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, your left leg to the sky, nice and long, so big stretch. Exhale, slowly and softly, left foot steps forward, lunge. With your in-breath, rise up, crescent one. Move with awareness, with intention. Exhale, cactus your arms, bend your back knee. Option to work the back bend. Thanks, Crystal. Inhale, back to crescent. Option to extend your front leg, straighten it out, engage to the front of your thigh. Exhale, hands to the earth, front knee bends. So you're in your low lunge position. Inhale, revolve lunge, left arm to the sky. Maybe follow your left fingertips with your gaze. Exhale, unwind, root into your left foot. Inhale, standing splits, right leg lifts. Spread your toes. Exhale, Shiva squat, get small, empty out of your breath. Inhale, standing splits, option to take one little hop if you want to. And then exhale, tuck and curl, so right foot to the top of your mat, get small, curl into yourself. Inhale, halfway lift, realign, re-lengthen. Exhale, plant your hands, step back to plank, you can hold here and wait, or inhale, Vashisthasana, left hand is your base, right arm to the sky, side plank. Good job. Exhale, plank or modified plank. Everybody lower down, chaturanga. Inhale, heart lift, shoulders back and down. Exhale, hips lift, spine long, downward facing dog. Take a great big inhalation into your dog pose. Exhale, look forward, empty out, step or float, top of your mat. With your inhalation, Ardha Uttanasana, spinal extension. Exhale, bow, Mixera, fold. Press into your feet, reverse, swan dive and stand. Back muscles hug around your spine. Inhale to reach up, stretch. Exhale, hands to heart center. One more round. Here we go, making a moving meditation. Inhale, high mountain. Exhale, bare pulse. So right foot steps to the right, butt back, arms forward, spine long. Inhale, high mountain stretch, open through the front of your hips. Exhale, other side. Get low, keep your spine long, don't let it round. Inhale, high mountain. And as you exhale, turn your back and do it with awareness, do it with strength in your back body. Exhale, flow all the way down, forward fold, nice cam. As you inhale, halfway lift. How much awareness can you bring into just the basic postures? Exhale, plant your hand, step or hop, chaturanga dandasana. Inhale to lift your heart, face Emily. And exhale, takes you back, Adho Mukha Svanasana. Big inhalation, right leg to the sky, lengthen it out. Use your core, exhale softly, right foot to the top of your mat. With your in-breath, crescent lunge, slow rise. So be present for your transitions as well. Exhale, turbo lunge, arch in the back bend if you would like. Inhale, back to crescent, perhaps straighten your front leg. Kind of a balance challenge. Exhale, hands to the earth, front knee again is bent. Inhale, revolve, lunge, right arm to the sky. Look up at your right fingertips, open up through the right side of your chest. Exhale, unwind, hands to the earth. Inhale, standing splits, left leg lifts, spread your left toes. Exhale, Shiva squat, left knee to the back of your right knee, curl in, empty out. Inhale, standing splits, option to take a little hop if you want. And then exhale, tuck and curl, your little tiny potato bug ball gets small. Inhale, halfway lift, realign. Exhale, clench your hands, step back to plank. Hold here and wait, or inhale, Vashisthasana side plank, right hand is your base, left arm to the sky, open it up, find your strength there. Exhale, plank or modified plank, slowly lower down, chaturanga. Nice crystal, inhale, heart lifts. Exhale, hips lift, you are almost there, stick with it. Inhale your left leg to the sky, big breath. Exhale, left foot steps to the top of your yoga mat, lunge. Inhale, rise up, strong legs, arms reach up. Exhale, turbo lunge, maybe back bend, up to you. Inhale, back to crescent. Option to straighten your front leg, make it strong and powerful. Squeeze through your inner thighs. Exhale, hands to the ground. Front knee again is bent. Inhale, revolve, lunge. Left arm reaches up. Follow with your gaze. Exhale, unwind. Now move into your left foot, standing splits. Breathe in. Exhale, Shiva squat, get small, right knee to the back of the left. Inhale, standing splits, maybe take one little baby hop. Exhale, tuck and curl, little potato bug ball, small as you can get, find your center. Inhale, halfway lift, extend, lengthen, realign. Exhale, plant your hands, step back to plank, hold here if you want, or inhale, side plank, right arm to the sky, left hand is your base, hips are lifted. Exhale, plank, chaturanga, lower down. Inhale, lift your heart. Exhale, your choice, down dog, child's pose, or hero's pose, seated meditation. Got about 5 breaths. Maybe you want to close your eyes. See if you can just simply observe, feel, experience what's happening inside your body. What's there? What's present? Feel the energy moving through your body. Sometimes I like to visualize it like stardust. Just see it moving into all the little spaces. Your breath has sped up, or if you've lost track of it, now is a perfect time to slow it down, smooth it out, make it bigger, stronger, and more powerful. As you are ready in your next couple of rounds, everybody be back in downward facing dog. leg to the sky. And then this time, open your right hip. So bend your right knee, squeeze your outer right butt cheek. Reach your right knee up to the right and then up towards the ceiling. Try not to sink into your left hand, your left shoulder, or your left hip, so your left inner thigh hugs in, your belly button lifts up. Keep your right foot active. See if you can lift your right knee a little bit higher. Take one more inhale. Exhale, right knee to your left elbow. So a little twist. Don't let your hips sink lower than your shoulders, chest square to the ground. Inhale, three-legged dog, stretch it out. Exhale, right knee, right armpit. So as high as you can get on your right arm, maybe even bend your elbows, add a little push-up. Nice, Josh. Inhale, three-legged dog. And then last one, knee to your nose. Scoop out your belly. When you are empty, set your right foot at the top of your yoga mat. Lunge. Now listen here. Revolve, lunge. So left hand stays down, right arm to the sky. And then this time, we're going to work into a variation of revolve triangle. So you might need to kind of scoot your left fingertips back. See if you can begin to straighten your front leg by lifting your right sit bone up and pressing the top of your right thigh back. Squeeze through your inner thighs. Stay balanced on the ball of your back foot. So your back foot, your back ankle are both really strong. Twist from your center. So bring out right from your belly button. See if you can reach your right fingertips higher like you're trying to touch the ceiling. Take two more rounds. Get your front leg as straight as possible and then twist to your very edge. Nice work, you guys. End of your next exhalation. Unwind, wide-legged forward fold, hands over to the left side of your yoga mat. So parallel your feet, straighten out your legs. Inhale to a halfway lift. Pause here, bring a little tiny bend into your knees and reach your arms out to the right and to the left. So palms face down, squeeze your shoulder blades towards your spine, and imagine you're trying to press your arms up towards the ceiling as you press your chest towards the ground. You can keep that little bend in your knees, or without letting your spine round, straighten your legs, engage through the fronts of your thighs. Nice work. Good, Nick. Take one more big inhale. Lengthen in all directions. Exhale. Let it go. Wide-legged forward fold. You've got about 5 deep breaths here. You can hold or you can explore in whatever way you would like. With you. Rather than checking out when I stop giving you cues, check in with yourself, check in with your body, check in with your breath. Take about 2 more full rounds and see what you can find, see what you can discover. Next time you inhale, halfway lift, and this time you can just keep your fingertips on the ground. Crawl your hands to the top of your yoga mat, rotate your toes to face forward so you're back in a lunge position. And then again, we'll take it into standing splits, left leg to the sky. Take a great big inhale, reach your left leg super, super high. Exhale, Shiva squat. Now listen here. So left knee is tucked into the back of your right knee. Try to keep your weight back in your right heel. Walk your fingertips forward until your spine is parallel to the ground. So spine nice and long. Keep your left fingertips down and reach your right arm up. So you're in a twisted one-legged chair pose. See if you can maybe even gaze up at your right hand. Squeeze through your thighs, the tops of your legs, and then bring out from your center. You guys are awesome. Take one more great big huge breath. Nice, Emily. End of your exhale, forward fold. Give your right leg a little shake out. All right, so from your forward fold, heel toe your feet out to the width of your yoga mat, and then bring your toes out interlace your fingers, steeple your index fingers. Don't let your spine round. So imagine you're trying to press your arms back, your chest forward. If possible, heels stay down. Maybe even pick up your toes and spread them. Good job. Take about two more deep breaths. Breathe all the way down into your hips, into your groin. End of your next exhalation. Fingertips come down, hips lift up. And then heel toe your feet in so they're either hips width distance or big toes touch, whatever you prefer. Inhale to a halfway lift, spinal extension. Exhale, fold. Root through your feet, rise all the way up to stand. Inhale to stretch super tall. Exhale, hands to heart center. All right, inhale, take your arms to the sky. Pause here, bring more weight into your right foot, so you're transferring all of your weight into your right foot. Bend your left knee, left heel towards your left butt cheek. Reach your left hand back, grab the inner edge of your left foot, so the big toe edge, and then see if you can start to hinge at your hips as you kick your foot into your hand and pull your hand back into your foot, dancer pose. So try, once you are hinging forward, to lift your chest ever so slightly, like you're doing a little baby cobra with your heart. Keep your hips square as much as possible, so tug in with your inner thighs. Good job, you guys. You've got about two or three more rounds, so you can explore it, you can fall in and out of it. Keep a little tone through your low abdominals and create your back bend through your mid and your upper back. I think this is one of the hardest balancing poses. Good job. Keep breathing. Soften through your face. If you fall out, be kind to yourself. No big deal. Take one last round. And listen carefully. You're going to find your way to standing staff. So slowly come back through a neutral spine. Release your left foot. Left knee lifts out in front of you now. So belly button pulls in and up. If you want to extend your left leg forward, go for it. Take one more big inhale. And then as you exhale, low lunge. Fingertips to the ground and toes to the back of your yoga mat. All right. From here, bring your back knee down gently. And you can double up your mat if you want extra cushion. Hands come up to your front thigh. Walk your front foot forward just a little bit. And then lean forward like you're trying to sit your right butt cheek on your right heel. Lift through your heart. Lengthen through. Fine. Stay here or arms to the sky. Nice job. You can stay here or your final option, hands behind your back, interlace your fingers, roll your shoulders back and down, shoulder blades hug your spine, maybe hands reach back, maybe even knuckles reach towards the ground as your heart lifts towards the sky. Stay tall through your low abdominals. You don't want to feel it in your low back. Lifting through your chest. Keep working your right hip closer to your right heel. Imagine you're trying to drag your right heel back and up towards your right butt cheek. Breathe bigger, breathe deeper. One more round. Nice, Sandy. If your hands are interlaced, inhale to re-extend. Exhale, hands to the earth. Plant your hands, lift your back knee, and then three-legged down dog. So right leg all the way back and up. Open your right hip, bend your right knee, and then option if you would like to flip your dog. So right tiptoes come down behind you, right arm reaches forward, heart lifts, hips lift, back muscles hug around your spine. Nice, Crystal. Take one more full round, your fullest expression. And then everybody, downward facing dog, both feet on the ground, both hands on the ground, walk it out. If you would like to take a vinyasa, you're more than welcome to just kind of reset before we do all of that on the other side. Reconnect to your breath. Feel into your body. Inhale, take your left leg back and up. Exhale, peel your left hip open, bend your left knee, squeeze your outer left butt cheek. Left foot stays active, so flex, point, or float. Now, make sure you're not sinking into your right shoulder or your right hip. Both hands are evenly and more inhale, so you're going to lift your left knee a little higher. Exhale, left knee, right elbow as close as you can come. A little twist. Inhale, three-legged dog, back up, find that length. Exhale, left to left, so as high as you can get, maybe add a little push-up. Nice cam. Inhale, three-legged dog. And then last one of class, knee to your nose. Scoop out your belly, then send your left foot forward, lunge position. Right hand stays down, left arm to the sky, revolve lunge. And then you'll probably want to scoot your right hand back just a little bit. Work your front leg as straight as you can. So lift your left sit bones up, up, up. Press the top of your left thigh back and see if you can get the front of your thigh to engage. So left leg gets super straight and strong. Your inner thigh squeeze and then twist from your center. Bring out through your spine. This is your revolve triangle pose. Back leg is strong. Pile on the ball of your back foot. Take two more breaths. See if you can reach even higher. Twist even further. Straighten your front leg even more. Awesome job, Sarah. End of your next exhalation. Unwind. Wide-legged forward fold. So hands over to the right side of your mat. Parallel your feet. Straighten out your legs. Inhale to a half-leg lift, and just like we did before, a little tiny micro-bend in your knees. Reach your arms out to the right and left, or this time, option to reach your arms straight forward like you're doing Warrior Three with your arms, with your spine. It's going to be a little more intense. Press your chest down, press your arms up, find more length. If you like, and you can keep that length in your spine, straighten your legs so engage the front of your stretch through the back. Take one more inhale. So much space inside your body. Exhale, let it go. Wide legged fold. Four or five breaths. Wherever you want to go. Be still or explore with movement. Up to you. Standing splits is where you will end up. So left foot roots, right leg lifts. You won't hold it very long. Spread your right toes, make your right leg super strong. Relax your neck. Big, huge inhale, lengthen. Exhale, Shiva squat. Right knee to the back of your left knee, right inner heel to right outer glute. Now, see if you can walk your hands forward so your spine gets long. Keep the weight in your left heel. Keep your right fingertips down, left arm to the sky, so start to peel the left side of your chest open. Nice. Maybe even gaze up at your left fingertips. Good, Sarah. Maybe bend your standing leg a little bit more. Reach your butt further back. Crown of your head further forward. Twist, twist, twist. One last round. End of your exhale. Forward fold. Release. Good job. You can give your legs a little shake out. This time, you choose any variation of a forward fold or a low squat. So, you might take gorilla pose, stepping onto the palms of your hands. You might grab your big toes with your peace fingers. Or you might come back to your little yogi squat, malasana, like we did before. Your tiny little potato bug ball. Lots of options. Give yourself about three rounds. Reconnect to your breath. So can you make your breath even stronger? We're getting near the end of class, so this is when I think it gets harder to keep the breath going. So if you can find your second wind, just stay here, stay present. Give every single second, everything you've got, and stay soft, stay kind. Jesus. compassionate with yourself. Awesome job, you guys. Next time you inhale, wherever you're at, we'll meet in a halfway lift. So realigning through our spines. Exhale, bow, fold in. Root through your feet and rise all the way up. Big full body stretch as you breathe in. Exhale, hands to your heart. All right, last balancing pose. Inhale, arms to the sky. Root into your left foot. Bring your right heel to your right butt cheek. Find your balance here first. And right hand reaches back to grab the inner edge, the big toe edge of your right foot. So the crease in your elbow points out to the side. Whenever you're ready, begin your hinge. So hinge up your hips. Try to keep your hips square. Kick foot in the hand, pull hand back to the foot. So you're creating like a bow, a line of tension that will help you stay balanced. Once you have found your hinge forward, you're kicking your foot into your hand. See if you can live through your heart. So back muscles hug around your spine, bottom tips of shoulder blades squeeze. Good, about two more rounds, your fullest expression. If you're falling in and out of it, that's where you're at today. Meet yourself there, that's perfect. Now see if you can stay balanced on your left leg. Slow transition to standing staff. Arms reach up, right knee lifts. Option to extend your right leg forward. Try not to lean back. Good, one last inhale here. Exhale, move in slow motion, low lunge. Try to tap your fingers and your toes down at the same exact time. Once you're in your lunge, back knee comes down, fold over the side of your mat if you want that extra padding, hands to your front thigh. Walk your front foot forward just a little teeny tiny bit, and then lean forward like you're trying to sit your left butt cheek on your left heel, but at the same time, your left heel is pulling back like you're trying to lift your left heel up towards your left butt cheek. Tone your belly, lift your heart, lengthen your side body. Stay here or arms reach. Stay here, or final option, interlace, hands behind your back. Just for fun, switch them to one finger over so it's your non-habitual way of clasping. Roll your shoulders back and down, perhaps arms reach back, knuckles towards the ground, heart towards the sky. Stay tall through your low abdominals to support and protect your low back. Breathe wherever you're at, make sure you can breathe freely. Can you work your left hip a little closer to your left heel? Send your breath down into your hips. One last round. If you have your hands clasped, next time you breathe in, arms to the sky. Exhale, hands down. Lift your back knee up. Three-legged down dog, left leg to the sky. Open up your left hip, bend your left knee. Great place to stay or option to flip your dog. Left tiptoes, come down behind you. Rotate your heart to look up at the sky. Lift your hips, good Josh. Breathe down into your belly. One last huge deep breath. And then downward facing dog, come back. Walk it out. Nice work, you guys. Take one last inhale into your down dog. Exhale, set your knees on the ground. We're gonna take a seated hip opener today. So however you wanna get there, find your way into a seat. And then we'll go with double pigeon fire log, but I'll give you options. So if double pigeon is in your practice, we'll go with our right shin on top. So bring your left shin parallel to the front edge of your mat, flex your toes, and then outer ankle to your inner knee. So a lot of times people like to put their foot inside their leg. Try to get your outer ankle all the way up to your inner knee. It might look something more like this, and if so, you sit up nice and tall. This is your pose. If your knee is even with your hip, then you can work with folding forward. So reach your butt back as you lengthen your spine. If this is not going to work for you, options are bottom leg is straight. You can sit up tall or fold, or bottom foot is on the ground with your knee bent, hands behind you. Try to lift through your chest rather than rounding your back. Wherever you have chosen to be there. Breathe there. ankles strong. So imagine your ankles are in a ski boot. They can't twist or sickle. Maybe close your eyes and visualize your breath moving down into your outer right hip. My friends, take one last huge breath. If you'd like, you can exhale out your mouth. And if you're folded forward, slowly rise back up. Uncross your legs. You might lean back, give your legs a nice little shake out. It might also feel good to take a quick reverse tabletop, or maybe just windshield wiper your knees from side to side. So whatever movement in between sides that feels good to you, that calls to you. And then no rush, but eventually start to find either that same hip opener on the other side, or if this side feels different, then listen to that. You might be able to take it a little bit deeper. You might want to keep it a little less intense. Through your jaw? Are you tightening up through your forehead, your eyebrows, your eyelids? Just by noticing, you can soften even. Twist today, but if one last twist would feel good, a supine spine twist, that's a great option. If there's an inversion you want to take, if there's one last heart opener you want to take, so whatever calls to you. And if Shavasana is what calls to you and you want to go straight there, that is absolutely fine with me. I feel like it feels like we don't have our feet on the ground. And I've just been trying each day to look at it as a new beginning. Each breath is a new beginning. So there really are no endings. There are only new chapters, new beginnings. You have to exhale in order to take your next inhale. You have to let go to create space and opening and possibility. For these last few moments, this is not necessarily the end of your practice. It is just the beginning of a new one as you go out into the world. So let your become all who have ever died or fallen. You touch that ancient silence born billions of years before Earth, rock solid amidst these changes. Sometimes all you can do is breathe. By Jeff Foster. So take a deep breath in, feel it, hold it, and exhale, release it. Slowly start to bring movement into your body, and when you're ready, roll to either side, fetal position. Using the strength in your arms, guide yourself up into a seat. So with eyes closed and hands gathered at heart center to close our practice. Just take one final moment here to bow your head to your heart. Acknowledge yourself, thank yourself, honor yourself for taking time out of your day to show up on your yoga mat, to slow down, tune into your body, connect with your breath, and ultimately just reconnect with you.